साई राम, हेलो एंड वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10th ज्योमेट्री क्लास. चिल्ड्रन, आई हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड यू विद द न्यू पेपर पैटर्न एंड इन दैट वी हैव सीन सम केस स्टडी टाइप क्वेश्चंस. एंड एज आई सेड दैट आई विल टेक द रिविजन ऑफ केस स्टडी टाइप क्वेश्चन. सो वी आर बिगिनिंग विद द ट्राइंगल चैप्टर. सो इन टूडेज लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम केस स्टडी बेस्ड क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस chapter, right? So before that, let me quickly revise the concepts which we have learned in this chapter. Do you remember which all things we have learned? We have seen the similarity between the triangles, two triangles, and different criterias for the similar triangle. What are the criterias? Side criteria, angle criteria, then side criteria. Then after that we have seen Pythagoras theorem, that in a right angle triangle the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides. Also we have seen the statement for converse of Pythagoras theorem. What is that? In a triangle, if the square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides, then the angle opposite to the first side is a right angle. This is converse of Pythagoras theorem. We have also seen areas of similar triangle theorem. Though the proof is deleted, but its application is there. So what is that areas of similar triangle theorem? That the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the squares of the ratio of their corresponding sides. Not only sides, it also equal to the ratio of the squares of corresponding medians, corresponding altitudes, and corresponding angle bisectors. Remember this because we are going to use this theorem many times. Even in today's lesson, it is useful. So let us begin. Question 1. Rahul is studying in 10th standard and he is making a kite to fly it on a Sunday. Few questions came to his mind while making the kite. Give answers to his questions by looking at the figure. So the first question was, Rahul tied the sticks at what angle to each other? So for this you should know the properties of that quadrilateral kite. What are the properties in kite? That smaller sides, they are congruent to each other. This AB and AD, they are equal. Two longer sides, they are equal to one another. Longer diagonal bisects the smaller one at right angles, right? And also this obtuse angle, they are also congruent to each other, opposite. Only one pair of obtuse angles are equal. So these are the properties of kite. So what is the answer for this question then? Rahul tied the sticks at what angle? Longer diagonal bisects the smaller one. So at 90 degree. Right. Now next question. Which is the correct similarity criteria applicable for smaller triangles at the upper part of this kite? Similarity criteria. We have learned only three criteria: angle criteria, side criteria, and side angle side criteria. So you can guess the answer very easily. Side angle side criteria. Otherwise you can prove here. See, this two sides, they are equal, Now here diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Because it's an isosceles triangle, base angles are congruent, right? And longer diagonal bisects the smaller one. That means AB upon AD, and suppose here is point O, so OB upon OD, and the included angles are equal. So by side angle side criteria, these two upper triangles are similar. Next question is, sides of two similar triangles are in the ratio 4:9. So corresponding medians of these triangles are in the ratio. As such, there is no direct relation between the sides and medians of a triangle, but we can connect them through this similarity criteria or by taking areas of similar triangle. As the triangles are given similar, so we know the ratio of the areas of two similar triangle is equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides, also the ratio of the squares of their corresponding medians. Okay, so sides are in the ratio 4:9, so medians, their squares will be 16:81. So in this way, the sides and medians, they are related. So therefore, 16:81 is the correct option, because 4 square 16, 9 square 81. Fourth one, in a triangle, if square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides, then the angle opposite to the first side is a right angle. This theorem is called as, just now we have discussed this. This is the statement of which theorem? Converse of Pythagoras theorem. So the correct option is option C. Don't get confused between the direct part and the converse part. In the direct part, right angle triangle is already given to you. Now next question, what is the area of the kite formed by two perpendicular sticks of length 6 cm and 8 cm? Children, do you have any direct formula for the area of kite? No. Right, but we can find the area of this kite by taking two triangles. You take triangle ABC. As both the triangles, they are similar, at the same time they are equal in area, so you just find out the area of one triangle and double it. So suppose AC is the base whose length is given 8 cm, and we know longer diagonal bisects the smaller one, and the length of the smaller diagonal is 6 cm, so each part 3 cm. Now you apply area of triangle, half base into height, so half into 8 into 3, so answer will be 12 cm. So area of one triangle is 12 cm. Now you double it, you will get the area of complete kite. So the double of 12 is 24 cm². So the correct option is 24 cm². Now, question number 2. A model of a boat is made on the scale of 1:4. The model is 120 cm long. The full size of the boat has a width of 60 cm. What is the width of the scale model? So let me show you the diagram. So this is the diagram of actual boat this is your actual board and this is model board. And what is the ratio of their scale factor? 1:4. This smaller ratio belongs to the model board and this bigger ratio belongs to the actual. Naturally, actual board will be bigger than the model board, right? So what is given? The model boat is 120 cm long. Its length is 120 cm. The full size of the boat has a width 60 cm. Boat means actual boat. So its width is 60 cm. What is the width of the scale model? So we have to find the width of the scale model. What is the ratio? Ratio here 1:4. Okay, that means the actual boat is 4 times bigger than the model boat. So to get the width of scale model, you need to divide this 60 by 4. So 60 divided by 4, the answer is 15 cm. So the width of the model boat will be 15 cm. What will affect the similarity of any two polygons? Okay, 4 different situations are given. You just have to say which condition or which situation will affect the similarity. First, if they are flipped horizontally. Let us take any figure. If that figure you flipped horizontally, draw horizontal line and along that line you flip it. Will it affect the similarity of that diagram? No, because it will remain as it is. The sides will be in proportion. Now they are dilated by a scale factor. Dilated means enlarge. So if we enlarge any figure, it will be in proper proportion, so that will not affect the similarity of that polygon. So this is also true. Now they are translated down. If they are shifted down, will it affect? No. And they are not the mirror image of one another. If the figure is not the mirror image, for example, if the mirror is say concave mirror, so in that mirror you will find the image larger than the actual image, right? Though the images are similar, their sizes are different. If the mirror is convex mirror, in that case the image looks smaller and far from the actual distance. That means the images are similar, but here it is saying they are not the mirror image. That means the polygon is not a similar polygon. So the fourth option will affect the similarity of two polygons. Understood the reason? Yes. Next question. See, if two similar triangles have a scale factor of 1:b, which statement regarding the two triangles is true? Right? So, you remember, if the two triangles are similar, then the scale factor of their corresponding sides, their corresponding medians, corresponding perimeters, corresponding altitudes, all are same. So therefore its correct option is option 2. So the correct option is option 2, that their altitudes have a ratio 1:b. Remaining 3 options are wrong. Understood? Yes. Next, the shadow of a stick 5 meter long is 2 meters. That means stick is 5 meter long and its shadow is 2 meters long. At the same time, the shadow of a tree 12.5 meter high is. Now see the diagram is given. For the shadow, the sun is seen here. Tree, its height is 12.5. You have to find the length of the shadow. Now we have two triangles and they are similar. By which criteria? See, tree and stick, they both are perpendicular to the ground. So this angle 90 degree, and the shadows are made at the same time. So this angle of inclination with the rays, this angle is equal to this angle. So these two triangles, they are similar by angle-angle criteria. Now you take the ratio of their corresponding sides as the triangles are similar. So 12.5 upon 5 is equal to x. Say length of the shadow of this tree is say x. X upon 2. Now you cross multiply and find the answer, find the value of x. So you will get its answer as 5 meters. Okay, so this you can do of your own. We have seen this type of question. Even in the exam, I had asked one question of this type. Okay, so but that was from trigonometry chapter. Now, the next. So the question is quite big. You read this question very carefully, then I will show you its diagram. Below, you see a student's mathematical model of a farmhouse roof with measurements. The attic floor ABCD in the model is a square. The beams that support the roof are the edges of a rectangular prism. E, F, G, H, K, L, M, N. Now E is the middle of AT, F is the middle of BT, G is the middle of CT, and H is the middle of DT. All the angles of the pyramid, all the edges of the pyramid in the model have length 12 meter. So let me show you the diagram. Yes, this is the diagram. See, the farmhouse left hand side, the complete farmhouse is shown here, and this is the model of only the roof, right? It is rectangular pyramid in shape with all the edges of length 12 meters. Now let us see what is the question based on this diagram. What is the length of EF, where EF is one of the horizontal edges of the block, right? Now, as per the question, we have given that E is midpoint of AT, F is midpoint of BT. See, this E, F, G, H, these are all midpoint. So, if I take triangle ATB, so E and F are the midpoints of sides AT and BT. And 9th standard, we have learned this midpoint theorem. What is that? A line segment passing through the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle, it is parallel to the third side and its length is half of the third side. Now third side is the edge of that pyramid whose length is 12 centimeter. So its half will be, half of 12 is 6. So the correct option is 6 meters, right? Not centimeter, meters. So this is all about today's lessons. So children, this is known as case study based questions. Do you find any difference in our normal question and this one? No. Right? So you can solve it very easily. Only thing, your concept should be clear. So that's all for today's lesson. We'll meet in the next lesson. Till then, goodbye.